my utmost. You know, we all have, if you're in information systems, you all know about computers that you can only do with the computer what it's programmed to do. You, as the creator of the program or of the computer, can program it to work in a certain way. Now, we know that we have like iPhones, and we program an iPhone to work in a certain way, that you're able to hit keys and it performs and functions in just that way as being a smartphone. Or you have a computer that you can go and, if it's programmed to, go on the internet and search for information and do all these things. But what most people don't realize is that you're a programmed creature. You have a programming that was instilled in you from your DNA to become the physical being that you are. Now, spiritually, when you become born again, you also have a programming that is being instilled in you by way of what you do, what you say, what you see, what you think, and what you feel. It's all going into your spirit. And you're going to take the spiritual part of you, your soul and your spirit, that is going to go to heaven, and you're going to deal with maybe a lot of information that you might not want to have inside your soul and your spirit that you programmed in there, that maybe you weren't looking in the right direction, or maybe you were programmed in a certain way. And you can change that programming at any point in time, because, you see, the Bible says, by way of God revealing it to us and His Holy Spirit, is that be not conformed to this world. So first of all, it says, don't let your programming be like the world's programming. But it says, be not conformed to this world, but be transformed, changed, reprogrammed, transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you might prove what is the perfect and acceptable will of God in Christ Jesus. And we are already told what God's will is for us. We are already told what Jesus' will was for us. And that was to reveal the Father, and for us to have a personal relationship with God our Father, as well as to know His Son and to have the Holy Spirit in us. In order to do those things, then we are told by way of our programming manual, the Bible, how to accomplish that. And being born again is part of it. But you still have to renew your mind. You have to kind of change the programming, because you see, you have a cache file that you have a temporary memory that's going to be cleansed, hopefully, before you appear in heaven, or you may be thinking some strange thoughts and you may have some weird ideas, and you can change your programming by adapting what the manual says to apply it to your personal life. Or there's another way. You see, because it's what we see also and what we feel, you could look at Jesus. You could be so heavenly minded that you're no earthly good or all earthly good by being so consumed with the idea of focusing in on the direction that God wants you to go. Meaning that when Jesus was here on earth, He said, I get up every day. Or did He? No, wait a minute. That would be Him witnessing for Himself. What did His disciples say that Jesus did? And Jesus awoke long before dawn and was gone in prayer. And Jesus said of Himself only this: I only do those things I see my Father doing. Oh. So, let's get this straight. We could program ourselves to only do those things that we see Jesus doing? Or has done? Or is it seeing what the Father's doing? In order to see the Father, we have to see Jesus, because Jesus said, if you have seen me, you've seen the Father. So when we see what Jesus has done, seeking the Father in the morning, programming his mind by what his Father told him to do, then we likewise follow in the same programming. We need to focus in on what we're programmed to do and to become sons and daughters of God. You see, it's not a Jewish thing, and it's not a Christian thing. It goes beyond that from creation. Because Judaism lasts as long as there's a world to exist on it. But once there's a new heaven and a new earth, what are we going to do? Judaism only began with Abraham, not with Adam. When Christianity is gone, as it will be, when there's a new heaven and a new earth, what do? When the religion has become the personage and the bride is now married to the Lamb. We have a reprogramming going on. And so you see, We are becoming sons and daughters of God. So we need to ascend out of this programming of the world and don't be conformed by it, by the things of the world or the voices in the world or the things we see in the world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. And the renewing of your mind comes through the watching of the Word and through letting the manual, the instruction manual, the programming manual, change your mindset so that you would not only see what Jesus is doing, but you would see Him doing it in you, with you, for you, and through you to all others around you as you are influencing people by your programmed responses that are now no longer of the world in defensiveness or, oh my God, but rather, oh yes, God bless you. Oh yes, I know you burned me, but guess what? It's okay because it's so temporary. I don't care about the house that burned down. I don't care about the children that got killed. What I care about is that they were saved and that they're going to be in eternity in heaven. So focus in on the program things that God would have for you. And you won't go wrong, because then you'll know why you exist. Springs of... Now there's a good English word. Benignity. Benignity. I think it's benignity, because it's from benign. The water that I shall give him shall be in him a well of water. The picture our Lord gives is not that of a channel, but of a fountain. Being filled. And the sweetness of vital relationship to Jesus will flow out of the saint as lavishly as it is imparted to him. As God blesses you, you'll bless others. If God isn't blessing you, I think you need to get something straight. If you find your life is not flowing out as it should, you are to blame. Something has obstructed the flow. Keep at the source, and you will be blessed personally? No. Out of you will flow rivers of living water, irrespective of your life. It's irrepressible. It's a artesian that just, boom, no matter what you do, say, or think, part of you is going to go, wow, man, I had a bad attitude, but guess what? The Lord used it anyways, and somehow He turned it around and made it into something that just flashed and washed and cleansed and blessed, and wow, look what He did. And it wasn't me. We are to be centers through which Jesus can flow out as rivers of living water in blessing to everyone, not just Christians, not just the friends, not just the people we get along with, but our enemies. Even those that despitefully use us, even those places where we are abused, even those circumstances that are just abhorrent, like, oh my God, a child abuser, no, he can't be saved. Or can he? Or a terrorist, oh my God, no, they're Muslim, so of course they can't be saved. Or can they? Oh no, they're satanic, they can't get saved. Or can they? Some of us are like the Dead Sea, always taking in, but never giving out, because we are not rightly related to the Lord Jesus. As surely as we receive from Him, He will pour out through us, and in the measure He is not pouring out, there is a defect in our relationship with Him. Is there anything between you and Jesus? Is there anything that hinders your belief in Him? If not, Jesus says, out of you will flow rivers of living water. If not, a blessing passed on, not an experience stated, but a river continually flowing. In other words, it's not a one-time thing that just happens, oh, well, you know, today I feel good, so I'm going to bless you, ha, and then tomorrow I'm going to curse you, ha, and then tomorrow I'm going to, you know, build you up, and then next day I'm going to tear you down, next day I'm going to stomp on you, next day I'm going to hide because I don't feel like it. One of the joys I have in doing these devotionals is that every day we're here. This is the way we record it. This is who we are. And I love part of it because it also reveals what the words can't say, the emotions cannot belie, is that you can see who it is in me and what it is that God works through me, and that it's not I, that in a lot of the words people misunderstand what they're saying or where they're coming from, but that in this devotional way, they can understand maybe in a more personal way where God has brought me from and where he's taking us to. Keep it the source. Guard well your belief in Jesus and your relationship to him at all costs. And there will be a steady flow for others' lives, no dryness and no deadness. It is not too extravagant to say that out of an individual believer, rivers are going to flow.
Oh, I don't see the river, you say. Never look at yourself from the standpoint of, who am I?
In the history of God's work, you will nearly always find that it has started from the obscure, the unknown, the ignored, but the steadfast true to Jesus. You see, in developing these devotionals and emotionals in a personal way was to cause you to come to recognize that there is something more for you. There's something more you can have. There's something more you can possess. And that is the reality of the living God. Not just an idealism. Not just a religion. Not just a pie-in-the-sky idea that you get to cut and slice and dice and pull out a piece, you know, and put some whipped cream on it, you know, and then maybe a little sugar, a little cinnamon, you know, and then put a little glass of coffee or milk or whatever you may have at Starbucks, you know, and then take a bite and say, okay, I got God. No. The reality of God living in you, with you, today right here, always about you, always with you, and always constant in everything you do. As I always keep saying on these videos, God, and my wife hates this part, so plug your ears. God is with you in the bathroom. You know, and for old people, they go, thank God. But for young people, it's like, oh, that's disgusting. And God is with you in the bed. And God is with you everywhere. So the reality is that know God personally, and he will reveal himself to you corporeally. He will show himself to you in more than you ever dreamed or imagined that it could be. And when you keep that relationship, that desire, that longing, that thirsting after knowing God in that way, he will come to you and keep giving you more and more. And as he does, it's not just for you to take in, because it's going to splash out on everyone. Kind of like how these videos came about in the first place. Kind of like how you got saved in the first place. Because somebody, somewhere, splashed out on you and got your programming straight. And so guess what? God wants to do the same through you, to you, by you, in you, and around you, to everyone that's connected to you in some way, in some shape, and in some form. You are a blessing, whether you know it or not. Thank you.